designed to update laws on money transmission and money laundering protections. While that implied that an era of laissez-faire opportunity in Canada would be closing for Bitcoin companies, many saw it as an encouraging sign. One that legitimized their industry and gave it the same treatment as existing financial services. Already, Canada's biggest cities were becoming mini digital currency companies. Toronto boasts an aggressive accelerator known as Bitcoin B7, Minnesota's digital wallet provider, CryptoKitties. Meanwhile, Bitcoin X generates a digital currency exchange. As the kind of person you want running the world's biggest digital exchange. During the hack attack of June 2011, the price dropped to 0, and the exchange had been down to the reverse. Without standing, the reverse
albeit in a way that would seem bizarre for modern financial institutions with normal auditing procedures.